number of graduates. So this is something which, again, coming back to the same survey, ICA has given out certain numbers or enrollment at graduate level, 2.8, it is 2 crore 83 lakh total enrollment at graduate level in absolute numbers. Rashtriya Avishkar Abhiyan, to encourage children towards learning science and mathematics. So the purpose is, Avishkar is related with science, so discoveries or innovations. So basically the idea is to increase the focus of students on science and mathematics and coming out with new innovations or new discoveries in science and mathematics. Inspire scheme, you must have read about Inspire scheme, that is also important. We already discussed Inspire scheme in our government scheme section on under Ministry of HRD. The full form is important and the provisions are important. I am not discussing the provisions here because we are going to discuss that in detail with the revision of government schemes again. Okay. The number of out of school children has declined substantially. Now this is as per census data, census 2011 data. Although I don't believe it, it's very, very unbelievable. Let's have a look at the data. So it says in the age group of 6 to 13 years, the number of children who do not attend schools is 3.81 crore. Marked decline from 5.8 crore to 3.81 crore in 2011. That is a 35% decline. It has also provided the reasons. The reasons are not available here. Okay, so the reasons basically are, they are mentioned here. First, supplementing household income, poverty. These are the major reasons that people are, or students are not able to attend schools and have to drop out. That is a very basic understanding that you need to have, not important from examination point of view. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, basically the idea is to have every student present in schools at least till elementary education, for elementary education till class 8. After that, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan ends, but then and therefore the enrollment also drops down. We discussed that after elementary education, the enrollment drops down to almost 94%, and then it's 25% when higher education starts. A committee constituted by Joint Admission Board has been created to increase the count of girls in basically IITs and other technical institutes. Okay, so the enrollment, present enrollment is 14%, is almost 8%. They want to increase it to 14%, 17% and then 20% by creating supernumerary seats. What this means is that they want to create additional seats for girls in these technical institutes, because not only in India but around the world, it has been found, it has been seen that girls are less available in technical fields. They are more driven towards creative fields, fields related to arts. But India wants to change that. The country wants to change that and have more girls, more equal ratio when it comes to technical institutes. Okay. Various steps taken to achieve academic excellence. We have already discussed institutions of eminence. A total of 20 institutions of eminence are to be created, which will be provided autonomy in creating their own courses, in administering their institutions, in hiring foreign authors or foreign professors. So that is the entire purpose of creating these institutions of eminence. To also promote innovation and teaching and research on other side. National Assessment and Accreditation Council grades and benchmarks. So they are going to be rated even after their creation. It's not that once they are created or provided this institution of eminence tag, that it is also, it is going to stay with them for their lifetime. They are going to be assessed and accredited on a regular basis by this particular council. Okay, so I have received certain, I'm receiving certain things where they are saying that you should be teaching a little slow. Okay, so I believe students are not able to catch up because this is a revision batch, and that is the reason that it's a little fast. So the purpose of the batch itself is that you are revising a lot of things. Okay, so once you're done with the batch, you can go back to these PDFs and read them again and again. That will give you some time. There are almost 50 pages that we have to cover, and that is the reason that I'm going a little fast. I'll try to go a little slow from the next one. Okay. So the next is a training program to link madrasa teachers and with mainstream education system. So the purpose of this particular training program is to link the madrasas with the mainstream education system that we have. The madrasa teachers or any other minority institution that is created, which is providing teaching of their traditional laws and rules and their traditional teachings, is basically not in line with what scientific and other teachings they're supposed to provide to kids. In order to create a link with them, the best way is to basically bring in the teachers rather than try to take out the students from those madrasas or minority institutions and bring them to mainstream education system. It's better to basically upgrade those madrasas. That makes more sense. So that has been identified by the government, which is a very good step. And keeping that in mind, now they've created a residential training program for teachers, in which they will be taught the new things. The mainstream education will be provided to those teachers in the form of training, and then they're expected to go back and provide those same teachings to their students. Okay, so that is what this training program is all about. The important things that we need to remember here is 3T: teacher, tiffin, and toilet. So these are the three things that they want to improve on, that the government wants to work upon: teacher through these training programs, tiffin through midday meal scheme, and toilets through Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So these three main purposes are being fulfilled, or the government is trying to fulfill these three things through these different programs. So it's a very good step. It is in line with what is required in our education system, because our education system is still very old. And on the other side, we have madrasas and different, traditional education systems, which are still providing traditional knowledge, not providing scientific knowledge or scientific education to the students. I hope that's clear. I'm a little slow now.